Hey everyone, along with Edubridge IAS, I'm Nitish Sharma and we are discussing important issues for UPSC prelims 2020. Today we'll be discussing the expected questions from the nomination of former Chief Justice of India as a Rajya Sabha MP. The Article 20 of the Constitution of India provides for the composition of Rajya Sabha, which consists of 233 elected members and 12 nominated members. The elected members, their composition is provided in the fourth schedule of the Indian Constitution. And there will be 12 nominated members who will be nominated by the President of India. Now, there can be many questions that can be expected in this year's prelims examination from this important news. Now, the first question that we can expect is the composition of Rajya Sabha is provided under which article? So it is provided under Article 80 of the Constitution of India. The another question that we can expect is how many nominated members are there and who nominates the nominated members in the Rajya Sabha. So there are 12 nominated members as provided in the Constitution. It is provided in the Article 80 and not the fourth schedule. So you have to be very, very clear that it is not in the fourth schedule, rather it is in the Article 80 itself. Now that nomination is not a discretion of the President of India. This nomination is on the aid and advice of the Council of Ministers. Now, from which fields a person can be nominated as a member of Rajya Sabha? For that, the Constitution of India has itself provided that the people having special knowledge and practical experience in the field of literature, art, science and social service, they can be nominated by the President of India. I am repeating it again. The people who are having special knowledge or practical experience in the fields of literature, art, science and social service can be nominated by the President of India on the aid and advice of the Council of Ministers. Now, a question that we can expect that whether a Supreme Court judge or a Chief Justice of India is eligible to be nominated or elected as a member of Parliament. Now, Article 124 provides for the qualification and the conditions office of a Supreme Court judge. Under the Article 124, there is no such limitation, and the only limitation that the Article 124 provides is that the Supreme Court judge may not appear or plead before any court within the territory of India. It means becoming an MP as an elected MP or a nominated MP is not a constitutional limitation. Therefore, the nomination is 100% constitutionally valid. Another question that we can expect is in the order of precedence. Though UPSC has not asked many questions from the order of precedence in the past years, but from the sake of keeping ourselves safe, we are understanding the order of precedence. So the Chief Justice of India, along with the Speaker of Lok Sabha, holds the order of precedence number 6, and the MPs, elected MPs, nominated MPs, Lok Sabha as well as Rajya Sabha, they hold the order of precedence of 21. So this question also we can expect. Along with this, we can also expect the changes in the number of seats allocated to the states and union territories in the Rajya Sabha. Because recently in the year 2019, there have been a Jammu Kashmir Reorganization Act that has changed the status of the state of Jammu Kashmir and reorganized it as a union territory, and also it has created a separate union territory, which is Ladakh. So we can expect the changes in the composition of Rajya Sabha. So at present, there are 233 seats that are provided to the elected members, amongst which 225 seats are given to the states and 8 seats are given to the union territory. I hope we have discussed this issue in detail, and for more issues, please subscribe to the channel Edubridge IAS so that we can discuss the important prelims topics for the UPSC 2020 examination. Thank you and all the best.